jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. Season of all.
Lonely parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow.
There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. Glowing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Are you ready for Christmas? Everybody have a good Thanksgiving. Eat more than you should. That's law, isn't it? Required to help do that.
Scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmas long, long ago.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
You sing it with us?
There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time.
You done heard me talk enough, but guess what? I'm only one of two MCs of this thing tonight, so you get a whole lot more of me. We talk about Christmas time, and one of the key players in this beautiful story was Mary, the mother of Jesus. And what an honor that must have been. Just a virgin maiden doing what she was expected to do. Carrying out her everyday responsibilities, just working, just being who she thought that she ought to be. And one day, this angel appears to her and informs her, "You have been handpicked by God to be the mother of the Son of God." Can you imagine? Now that's a, of course they didn't have telephones back then, but that's a phone call right there, isn't it? That is a revelation. And I can understand her reservations, her hesitations, her shock, her excitement, her disbelief, all those emotions bottled up into one. She was responsible. They had heard for years that he was coming. But he was coming, and he was coming through her. And what an awesome responsibility that she had and that Joseph had in raising and being responsible for the Son of God who would bring eternal life to the entire world. This is no new song to you, but still a very special one to us. So listen as Dad comes and sings and we join him on Mary, Did You Know?
Walk on water, Mary did.
would save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? Your little baby boy would soon We talk about Mary, and that's much of the Christmas story. What we don't know a whole lot about is Joseph. We hear very little about Joseph in the Bible, and that's to give not credit to Joseph for being the father, but our Heavenly Father. We understand that. But can you imagine how Joseph must have felt? And he was a just man. He was a good man. We know that because of the way he treated Mary. But this is a song that kind of tells a story, and it's from Joseph's perspective. It's very odd, very different. If I had been in charge of saving the world and sending a Savior, I probably would not have done it by sending him the way he came and in a manger. I probably would not have done it. Probably been a lot more pomp and circumstance, but God does a little different than we do. But I want you to listen as Caleb comes and he sings the song, Such a Strange Way to Save the World.
You must have been surprised 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. And why here with all the rulers in the world? And why here inside this stable filled with hay? And why her? She's just an a strange way to save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way, such a strange way, a strange way to save the world.
He came to us in such a strange way. But you know what? It was a perfect way because of God's perfect plan. And when we could not go to where he was, he came to us. This is probably one of the most untraditional Christmas songs you will have ever heard. Fact is, it wasn't even a Christmas song. And Caleb brought it to us and said, I want to do this song for Christmas. I said, heard it all my life. Never known it to be a Christmas song. But the more I listened to it, the more they did it, the more I realized, hey, it can be a Christmas song too. I told them, I said, when Christmas is over, we're going to keep the song on the set. But it works, and it simply says, he came to me. Kind of a summary of the entire Christmas story, how that Mary wrapped a little baby in swaddling clothes, and it was the greatest gift ever given to mankind. I'm going to take just a minute and introduce us to you. On my far left are those of you who have never seen us before, is my oldest son, Cody, and he is with us full time now, and we're glad to have him after he finished his pastoring requirements and his duties, and he drove back and forth. I may have told y'all that drove back and forth to Grootley Lager, Tennessee. Anybody heard of Grootley Lager? You can't even get there from here. Just telling you. He drove back and forth, he and his wife, every Sunday and Wednesday, and pastored the church there. We're happy to have him with us full time now. And next to him is my darling wife of 30 some odd years, and I'll just leave it right there. They ask me every time, they say, because you don't know, but I do.
You don't know.
So, I do know. And that was just this week. But anyway, that's Jonna. You happy to see Jonna with you again? Behind her is our youngest son. Sometimes he's mine, most of the time he's hers. That's Caleb. Caleb's been with us from the beginning here. And then step out here, short stuff. All the way from Kentucky. One of them northern Alabama counties, you know what I mean. Is Anna, that's Caleb's wife, and they've been married almost 3 years, and they've just got back today from spending Thanksgiving with her folks, and we're happy to have them back home safe from Kentucky. And this is Heather, this is Cody's wife, and Cody and Heather are the parents of the world's most perfect grandchild, and he's sitting right down there, and we're glad to have him. Y'all welcome, y'all happy to see the Shaneyfelt family with you one more time? We're happy to be here. Jonna sings a song that talks about Jesus. It's called Mary's Little Lamb.
I'm sure you've heard the
At times, we get to swap up, like the boys got to sing with their mother a few minutes ago. I get to sing with my daughter-in-laws. They allow that at times. And sometimes they look at me and just say, shut up, we got it. So once you listen to Anna sing, it's New Star Shining. This is probably one of the most beautiful Christmas songs I have ever heard. The lyrics are so great. We talk about Christmas gifts. We talk about Christmas trees. We talk about this and that. And we relate it all to Santa Claus. And we relate to giving the gifts. But really, I don't know where we went south in America and in the world, but Christmas has become so commercialized. And we've forgotten what the real meaning really is. But God gave his very best. I'm going to say that again. God gave his very best for me and you. He came and he gave himself to us. And what a great gift that is. And we forget about that sometimes. We get wrapped up in what is going on in the world with the decorations and with the lights. And I love all that. It's my favorite time of the year. But this is why we love him. And this song says, this is why we adore him. Yeah.
understand why we celebrate this day. They wonder why we worship every time we speak His name. When we sing, "Come all ye faithful, let us adore the King," we are looking past the stable to a hill called Calvary. That's why we adore Him. That's why.
Have a problem talking about the Christmas trees. They don't have a problem talking about Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. Grandma got run over by a reindeer. Jingle bells. They don't have a problem talking about the star. But when you start talking about the Savior, there's a conflict. And I'm glad that He came, even as a little baby, to be my personal Savior. I'm glad of that, aren't you? Amen. So we're gonna lighten it up just a little bit. Gonna let Caleb play for you here a little bit. And now I just got through saying something about jingle bells and stuff like that and silver bells. So y'all don't follow that with me on. Y'all listen. He started playing this when he was about 16 years old, and he plays it different every time he ever plays it. I don't know how he's gonna do it this time, but silver bells. You like that? I like that.
product table, we're going to bring them to you, okay? Woo! All right, here we go.
Snow outside is falling as we wrap the Christmas gift. We're keeping lots of secrets till December 25th. We are looking back to Bethlehem, where the little boy was born. We're celebrating Jesus, the Savior of the world.
Savior of the world. Christmas time is the best time of the year.
Christmas lights are glowing, I hear laughter in the air, and when I look in their eyes, it makes my heart cry. There's an emptiness they just can't hide. There's something inside me I want them to see. Let them see Jesus shining through me. I want them to see that what they really need is Jesus. What good are Christmas lights without the light of the world shining out of my life? I'll throw my heart wide open. Someone who's passing by, or someone who walks through my door. So many are hurting this time of year. They all need the love of the Lord. Though everybody's busy, I'll go the extra mile. Light up the darkness with a hug and a smile. This world needs a Savior, and I want them to know that Jesus is in me. I've got to let it show. I'll be a light in somebody's life this Christmas.
When we were here last, we did a snippet. You remember the snippets we did? Some of our better songs, I think, we did for snippets. We're gonna do the snippets again for you. we've seen some folks here that we haven't seen in a while, and some we have never seen here, and we're so glad to see you being visitors and become a big part of this. We're very thankful for that, but we want you to hear, listen to this song. We did this one back in, when were we here? Then May was it? About May, when we first started putting together the Christmas tour, so we started working on this, we said, we'll give you a snippet of what we're going to be doing for Christmas. And this was one of those we did, and this is I Call Him Lord. And people have a lot of different names for him, but this is a fantastic song, I Call Him Lord.
Thank you.
He's been a lot of things in my life. What about you? I've known him to be a friend, known him to be a comforter, known him to be a healer. Anybody else identify with any of that in your life? Amen. He's good to us, ain't he? He's good to us, ain't he? You read a lot, you read in the scriptures, and you read different portions of the Christmas story and things that surrounded that time in the time leading up to it and in the years that followed. And, he grew older, as it was in the custom to do so, they would take the children back to the temple to dedicate them back to the Lord. And this song here simply says, "I've been to heaven, though I've never left the room," is another one of those snippets that we did on the main tour leading up to the Christmas tour. It talks about Simeon, the priest. And it says that, all his life he had heard about the coming of the Christ child. And when Mary and Joseph brought him in that day, and he took that baby, the Christ child, in his arms, he looked toward heaven and said, "Now I can die in peace, because I have seen salvation. I've held him with my hands, seen him with my eyes, I've heard him with my ears. I am now ready to die." What a wonderful experience that must have been. But you know what? Even greater than that, Simeon held him in his hands. And when he left there, he left there. But you know what the great part about this is? We get to hold him in our hearts, and he goes with us everywhere we go. Listen to this song that talks about, "I've been to heaven, though I've never left the room."
Amazing grace, my ears have heard the voice of God. Christmas.
We love y'all. Thank you, Pastor Deachers.